Stay right there in your easy chair for 30 minutes of pleasure. Don't you go, it's Melinda's show. It's the talk of the desert.
It's the talk of the desert with Melinda Reed.
I just love coming home at night. I turn around, she's a treasure. Everyone and everywhere I go, she's the talk of the desert.
Now, here's Melinda.
Atta baby.
Good.
Woo! Nice athletic swing. Stick ball, stick, 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 stick. Ah, we're putting.
Shots out. All right, Wilson's out. We've got to come.
Andy, you up?
Talk of the Desert is on location for the 28th annual Frank Sinatra Celebrity Golf Invitational at Fantasy Springs Casino. This is the 28th annual year. It's unbelievable. We've got terrific guests. We've got lots of celebrities. We have a lot of golf. And it's just wonderful that everybody can join us. And it's like old home week. Everybody here is so warm, so friendly. And I always encourage people to come out and come to the golf course and just stand there and watch the golfers golf. And they'll shake hands and they'll sign autographs. Bring the record albums, pieces of paper, photographs. They will take care of you. It's just really wonderful. And thank you for joining me.
Oh, here's your pen.
All right, you don't need a pen.
I just
stay
right there.
A picture with you.
Right there.
Well, joining me is actor and comedian. Maybe acting is funny. Yeah. I don't know. But Jackie Flynn. Jackie, welcome to Talk of the Desert and the Desert.
Well, thanks for having me.
You're welcome. But you've called me, I think, twice since you arrived in town because you wanted to make sure you got on my TV show.
Yes, I wanted to make sure I could do whatever I could to help out the cause and talk a little bit about it. And, you know, as a comedian and an actor, we get to do a lot of these, so it's always fun to, you know.
Well,
it's what's hard about it, really.
And you're here to support the Barbara Sinatra Children's
yes.
Center and the children
yeah.
that need our help, which is just amazing.
Couldn't be a worthier cause, I think, you know, and
that's
especially
right.
having children of my own, and as most people do, it's I'm always at a loss for people that, hey, what's wrong with people?
You know, I don't know.
Just, so, obviously, I wish there wasn't a need for this type of thing, but, you know, there is. So.
There is. Sadly, there is. Even yeah. in our community here in the desert, which has all economic levels, but,
yeah.
and I guess that abuse affects all economic
yeah.
levels.
I wish they'd just abuse, like, middle-aged guys like myself. Why do they get to abuse kids, you know, or an elderly, you know? Abuse someone that can take it, at least,
just,
you know?
I just don't understand it at all.
No.
Not at all. Jackie, tell me about, are you play golf?
I do.
Okay.
I'm a golf nut, yeah. You know, I mean, I love it. I'm not great. You know you're not a good golfer when people out on the course, they think you're like, nice hustle. Oh, thanks, you know. So, I hit one so far into the woods last week, I ran into Bear Grylls, the survivalist guy.
Oh, you did,
in case,
huh?
In case you didn't know who that was.
Okay.
You know.
You
but,
hit it that
yeah,
far,
yeah,
is that right?
A squirrel over a roasted fire is pretty good, actually. It's not
is,
bad.
Yeah. Is it? Did you have to leave a trail of breadcrumbs to
I
find
did,
your way back?
I did, just to get myself
yeah.
back to my partners.
Yeah,
but,
okay.
No, I really do enjoy the game.
Good. And you see, you said you live here in California.
Southern Cal, originally from Boston,
uh-huh.
and I moved to Hollywood, California. Like 20 years ago.
You're
which
an
is,
actor, right?
Yeah, well,
yeah.
going from Boston to
yeah.
Hollywood's kind of weird, you
yeah,
know, because
yeah.
I grew up, you know, on yeah. Earth, pretty much. So a little different.
And
know?
And Hollywood is not Earth, is that right?
Yeah, well, Hollyweird, we call it, right? So,
but,
you know,
it's
fine.
It sure
I like the weather, you know, so.
Well,
it's great.
Hard to beat, you know.
No, can't beat
so
it.
Tell me some of the movies you've been in.
I've been in Kingpin, Something About Mary, Me, Myself, and Irene.
I love that Pickles, movie.
The Boom,
I
Mall
love that
Cop.
Movie.
Oh, dear, yeah.
Yeah, I love it. Hilarious.
I've been, trying to think what else. National Security, Shallow Hal.
Guess what? You're a working actor, huh?
I'm trying. I'm not a big, nobody knows who the hell I am, to be honest with you, but, you know, I've been, I'm kind of like Fine Waldo in the movies, you know. I'm a kind of a.
Well, know. Yeah, but you may not be the star of the movie, but I have found that a lot of people that are character actors.
Yeah.
They've been in hundreds of movies, and they've made a living all of their
life. Oh, it's great. I mean,
instead of having to wait tables.
No, it's great. I am a character, so I have that going. But no, I do most of my stuff is stand up, but I do the odd movie now and again, and I love it. As a comedian, it's a thrill to be able to do like comedic movies, especially the Farrelly brothers are my champions, and they put me in a bunch of movies. And Kevin James, a buddy of mine, and I've been in some movies with him. And I was on the TV show The King of Queens for a bunch of episodes, so it's been fun.
That's just fabulous.
And you get to do things like this.
Okay, so now you've got an open microphone. Give me some comedy.
Oh no, Jesus! I just now you put me on the spot.
I thought you were a comedian.
It has to be TV ready too.
That's a joke. He called me yesterday and he said should I be camera ready? And I said, I'm camera ready when I'm even carrying the garbage
when you
out
wake
of the
up,
garbage
you're camera
can.
Ready. Yes, I'm not. For me, I just came back. Actually, we do a lot of it. I just came back from performing over there for the troops.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
Where's over there?
Not over in Afghanistan, just at the local Boy Scouts, Troop 87. But the Scouts, they love the comedy. Don't kid yourself.
You got me.
Oh, you thought
you
I meant Afghanistan.
Me.
That's dangerous. What do I look like, a hero? Good night, everybody.
I like that.
Thank you.
Yeah, I like
Merv,
that.
Merv, where do I sit?
Yeah.
All right.
That's cute.
Thank you.
Well, enjoy your time here at the Frank Sinatra Celebrity Golf Invitational. We'll look forward to seeing you around the tournament and enjoy the golf.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Jackie Flynn. Take care.
Yes.
It's like a little floating camera thing.
It's like, Sherry cam.
Sherry cam. Is the Sherry cam. I have to wear it on my hat. But
that'd be cool. Oh, that's my understudy.
So what are we saying? What am I talking about?
How are we doing today?
I'm actually having some pretty decent moments. I've only got one drive done, although I had a couple of good ones, but we've had better ones. Yesterday, always the first 18, I was stellar. Second 18, I'm going, oh, Jesus, I'm 62. Really? Seriously? 2 days in a row? What's going on?
What are you talking about? You're shooting 62.
No. Nice. I am serious.
Okay, see, now I'm going to have to edit that out.
Sherry was very disappointed
shooting 62.
That's right.
You know what? I mean.
But my team, thank God, is carrying us so far, and this is serious. I think we've had one par, one bogey, and everything else has been a birdie. So we had two eagles. So I think we're like at 12 holes. I think we're like 9 solid 10.
Oh, you guys are living good.
Oh, and there's my team from yesterday. Oh, and they're so happy not to be with me. You made it.
I made it.
Because you guys were like missing.
Yeah.
I thought we heard you were in the casino, right?
Yeah.
Oh, you thought you were playing with me, so you stayed to be late. Oh my God, so rude. Have a good time. There you go. Another fabulous day in sunny Indio Palm Springs area. I love it. Peace out.
Well, we actually have somebody who's on radio, actually on television on Talk of the Desert. Joining me is Dan McGrath. Dan, welcome back for about the 15th million time to Talk of the Desert.
Nice to see you, Melinda. It's funny she said, because I was thinking on the way out here, what year is this for this great event? And it's my 17th year. And I how can that be possible? But yeah. Here we are again.
Yeah,
so good to see you.
Yeah, it's good to see you. Well, tell us about your radio show.
Well, this is my 40th year in broadcasting, so radio, television, voiceover. But 17 almost here in the desert with CBS-owned Sunny 103, which was Easy 103 for a long time.
See, and I wanted you to say that because I might get that confused.
It's basically the same music, same everything, but we just changed that a little bit. It was a year ago Christmas time, and everything's great, and we're just going along like we always do. So,
well, what time do you start in the morning?
I start at five. Oh no, you want to really? I get up at 3:30, which is night.
Mm-hmm.
It's dark.
Any time of the year, it's night.
Night, and of course I'm on at 5 till 10. Yeah.
It's amazing. How can you do that many hours of that little bit of sleep?
You know, believe it or not, naps are the thing to do now. And Melinda, seriously, I mean, I've been taking naps for a while now. And it can't be too long. Then you're too tired when it's night. You know, whatever. But so that's the thing.
Yeah.
Little break in there somewhere.
And you do interviews with all sorts of celebrities like I do.
Sure.
To see, radio's a lot easier than television.
Yeah, yeah, you're right. I think it is too, because I've done a lot of TV too. And the thing is, we are a music station that interviews people too. It's primarily on Fridays. We call Friday Live.
Right.
And we've been doing that for a long time, and a lot of great guests like you and a lot of other folks over the years. So, yeah.
Thank you. Well, thank you, Dan.
Yeah.
Well, what's coming up for you in the future? Just more radio.
More radio. You know, as you well know, being here a lot longer than me, this is our great time of the year. It's just nonstop event after event after event after event. And you got to think, Melinda, I mean, it used to be by maybe April or so, it's pretty much over. Now it's almost year-round.
I know it is.
There's a little bit of a break, but not much. And there's great events. There's more people in the Valley all the time. And I find that funny because I'll talk with people where I'm from, which is Wheeling, West Virginia, which is that far from Pittsburgh. Yeah, I came here from Nashville, with Regina, of course. But the thing is people have this concept that we live in this little tiny town, listening, of course, to the great Frank Sinatra, and everyone's around the pool having drinks. Well, that happens. But it's 500,000 people almost. Yeah. And then when the season's on, it's double. So it's not like people think at all.
No.
People know Palm Springs, but they don't know all the other towns, with the great nine cities or whatever here in the desert. So it's a great place to live.
Well, I've been stuck here in traffic in August. And I'm thinking, I'm stuck here in traffic in August. What's it going to be like in January and February?
It's true.
You know?
And it's changed a lot. It really has.
It sure has.
There's a lot of people here.
Yeah, yeah.
And even the scenery coming, I thought, I'd never get here. So, yeah.
Well, Dan, I have to ask you.
All right.
Are you going to wear those pants or those shorts?
Oh, those
with the multicolored.
Yes, I will
golf
be. As a matter of fact,
okay,
I have two brand new pair this year.
Oh, you do?
I haven't even had them on yet. And they're pretty loud. But see, the advantage
you
is...
You just like to draw attention to yourself, is that right?
No, they're just easy because they're like Garanimals for men. Because they all have about 10, 12 colors. So you can wear 10 or 12 different shirts and like that. So,
that's
drives
the secret,
Regina
is
nuts.
That right? No joke. I think you're driving me nuts.
Yeah, there's
well,
a lot of you.
Dan McGrath from Sunny 103.1. Thank you for joining me as
thank
always.
You, Melinda.
And whenever you need something, you let me know.
Likewise.
Okay.
All
thanks,
right.
Dan. Appreciate
see you
it.
On the course.
Okay.
Turn.
Well, and now, next, in line. It's been a crazy day. It's Sean Thorson. He's the director and executive, officer of the Barbara Sinatra Children's Center.
I am.
And John, thank you so much for your service you do for the Children's Center.
Oh, thank you. It's great. And the support that you give us is wonderful.
Well, thank you, John. I have to talk first, before we get to the golf tournament this year.
Sure.
You just had your...
Champion Honor Center. And you were there.
And I was there. And I want to tell you, it was fantastic.
Oh, good.
Hank Aaron.
He was great.
Interviewed by Bud Selig, the former commissioner of baseball.
Very good friends.
It was excellent.
Good.
It was just excellent. And it was fun because it was hamburger and hot dogs for the luncheon and all this stuff. It was terrific. Everything was done perfectly. So I wanted
you
to know
you.
That.
It was very successful financially for the Children's
good.
Center, too. We
good.
Got... about 80 new aunts and uncles, and another 80 or so renewed, and with the sponsorships and everything, it was over $250,000 for the Children's Center, which
fantastic,
is great. You know,
fantastic.
For a one-day event, that's pretty good.
No, that's true.
See, I mean, 700 people for a luncheon in this community is good, too.
Yeah, that's right. Well, let's talk about that. Children that come to the Children's Center, there's never a bill that goes out to them that they can't pay,
If they can't pay, that's absolutely correct. And that was really Frank's idea. I mean, he just said he does not want to turn any child away for a family's inability to pay. So... We do. I mean, we just don't do that, and they don't get a bill. And we ask them, you know, what if you can afford $2, pay us $2. If you can't afford anything, you can't afford anything.
Really?
Yeah, we're going to help the child. That's what's important.
Yeah. Well, the Children's Center started in 1986?
Correct.
Okay, and this is, and now we're in the 28th annual Frank Sinatra Celebrity Golf Invitational. It's
so
a fundraiser.
Only 1 year removed from the Children's Center opening the first golf tournament happened.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's just wonderful.
It is.
And how long have you been with the center now?
A little bit over 4.5 years.
And you told the story, but just briefly tell how your interview went with Mrs. Frank Sinatra, Barbara.
Well, she tells it better than me, but I'll go ahead and
just briefly.
I got a call from a recruiter. I was living in Seattle and said, could you come down and meet Mrs. Sinatra on Thursday? And I said, sure. So went down and met her at her penthouse in Beverly Hills and knocked on the door. And Bob Marks, her son, answered and said, we're going to go back here. I said, oh, okay. So I walked back there. Well, little did I know, I was walking into her bedroom, and she was in bed, and she said, she couldn't remember my first name. She said, Mr. Thorson, you can go ahead and sit at the end of the bed. And she sat there, and we chatted for a while. She petted Sir Winston.
Yes, that's a doggy.
We had a little lunch, and Bob said, oh, Mom's got to take a nap. And I said, well, I guess it's over. She said, yeah. And I said, is there anything else I can say? And Barbara said, no, you've said enough. And I walked out, and they called me the next morning. And now I'm here.
And you got the job. That's fabulous.
That's absolutely.
That's probably one of the most interesting job interviews anybody's ever had. You realize
It was very hard, Melinda, as you can imagine, to pay attention, because it wasn't just the fact that I was in Barbara Sinatra's bedroom. It was the fact that on every wall is a picture of Frank with every Pope, every entertainer, Oscars. He's everything all over the place, platinum records, so it was tough to pay attention.
Yeah. Well, let's talk about the Children's Center, because you're involved every day. When somebody comes to the Children's Center, is it a law enforcement person that brings the children to the center, or what happens?
Well, as an example, and this really speaks to the epidemic of child abuse.
And I can't believe in this community, we have all economic levels, but in this community, it doesn't matter what economic level
you are. Oh, no, absolutely not. So, but last year, law enforcement did 300 forensic interviews at the Children's Center. So that's one every weekday, if you want to put in those terms. 300 children suspected of being abused.
Unbelievable.
I mean, if we can help those kids, that's what we need to do. But, you know, we're also working on awareness and prevention. You've seen in the papers, you know, there's been horrible stories of kids. And there was one not too long ago where the little girl, during the forensic interview, the interviewer said, well, would you have told your mother what happened? And she said, absolutely not. I didn't want to get in trouble. Well, we need to teach these kids to shout, to run, and to tell.
That's right.
What we're working on now. And in addition to treatment, we're going to work on a lot more of awareness.
Well, something we saw at the luncheon, which was the first unveiling of these videos.
Yes.
It's the first in the nation, and it's fantastic. Just tell us about these videos.
We essentially have hired a great company out of Los Angeles, Wonder Grove. Terry Thorne, who's the CEO, was the animator for the Rugrats movies. Very well known. He's now kind of moved out of the Hollywood scene and gotten into educational animation. We hooked up. We created four characters. A little girl, Sarah, who is 8. Her friend, Lenny, who is Asian boy. He's 8. And then two older characters for the older kids. An African-American and a Latina girl. So the series of videos are short, about 2 minutes long. They teach their protect yourself rules. They'll go from K through third grade for one group and then 4 through 6 for the other group. We are producing them at a pretty expensive price, as you can imagine. But our board is very committed to doing this.
They're excellent.
Here's the best part. We are going to make these available to every school, every
fantastic.
Boys and Girls Club, and every parent in this country free of charge.
Fantastic.
Yeah, it's great.
Congratulations,
yeah,
John. And this, it was just great to see these videos. And I could think how it affected me. I can imagine a younger child how much it would. And it would open up the conversation for a child.
As you saw Sarah, she's very cute, but she's also very confident. And she and I think kids will look up to her and say, if she can talk about it, I can talk about it.
Who developed this video?
Wonder Grove.
Okay, Wonder Grove.
Yes.
And so then, they're writing each of these things?
No, no, no. We've actually had writers, and then we also retained the services of a gentleman by the name of Dr. John Conte, who was a leading expert in the United States on prevention of child abuse. He is a professor at the University of Washington. I got to John by looking at a number of children's books on awareness of abuse and talked to him. Very interesting, short story. I started talking to him. He absolutely loved what we were doing. He said, I will help. In fact, I'll do it for free. And I said, well, geez, I'd love to get together and show you around. He says, oh, I've been to the Children's Center. I was there 25 years ago.
Oh, really?
He says, that place is phenomenal, and that's the reason why I'm going to help you.
Oh, fantastic. Oh, isn't that wonderful?
Yeah, that's great.
Yeah, it is, John.
So.
Well, anything else you want to share about the golf tournament or the Children's Center?
Well, you know, it's going to be a fun weekend,
it
as
is.
You know. Started out last night for me because we had the Brown-Forman dinner, and all their executives, they decided to do it outdoors at the Children's Center. It was wonderful.
Oh, I bet it was.
Yeah, it was great.
That's
so that was kind of our kickoff, and now we have the fun part.
That's right. Going to play some golf here this
play
weekend.
Play some golf, that's right.
John, thank you for
thank
joining
you.
Me. I really
okay.
appreciate it.
Thank you for all
thank
your support,
you.
Too.
We've got a buddy.
Nice putt.
Thank you.
Well, joining me is Carol Connors. And Carol, you helped write the theme to Rocky, so I feel like I should be running upstairs or something like that. So
I do run upstairs
do
every day
well,
at my house.
Well, that's great exercise for
to my
you.
Own theme. I co-wrote it. I co-wrote
it
with Bill Conti, of course, and Ann Robbins. And, of course, you know, Sylvester Sly,
yeah, Sly
is up for an Oscar right now for Best Supporting. And I can imitate him. You want me to imitate
yes,
him?
Yes, imitate him.
Hey, okay, what do you want to do? So that means, Carol, I got to win it. So I'm hoping he wins, and he has my vote, and I do vote in the Academy.
Oh, do you really?
Yes.
Tell me about that process of voting for the Academy, because there's only a few, what, thousand people, a couple thousand?
There's 6,000 in all.
6,000?
And which is not very many, because when you get down to it, there's like, I think it's 20,000 in the Grammys and 16 in the Emmys, 1,000. So we're sort of like small. But it's a two, their theory is this. Everybody votes their branch, because their theory is, if I'm gonna be in music, I should know what I'm doing. I'm
right.
in the Academy, I've
right.
been up for Oscars.
Right.
So I would know how to pick the best songs. So my branch, music, votes music, score, and best film. We all vote best film.
Mm-hmm.
The first go around.
Right.
Directors vote directors, best film. Actors vote actors, best film. And then the five nominations come out. And then the whole branch, everybody votes on everything.
Do you know, I've never really known the process.
That's the process.
It is. That's fascinating.
Yeah, it is.
Fascinating.
I think it's pretty wise in many ways, because I think that their theory is you know, all these people, they've been up for Oscars, or they've won, or they have a body of work, so they should know what they're doing.
You would hope so.
I don't think they do, but that's
bizarre. Well, is there some politics that plays part of this, too?
You haven't been reading the news?
Yeah, I guess so. Okay.
I mean, it's boycott and whatever.
Yeah, yeah.
They wine you and they dine you, but, you know, the bottom line is I'm still going to make up my own mind.
Right.
I mean, I know what film I'm getting. I'm doing my ballot tomorrow.
Good.
Because it has to be in by Tuesday. And I know what I'm voting for best film. and Best Supporting Actor.
And you're
Neo
not...
Rocky. Creed.
I think we got it. I think we know what's going on here, Carol. So, what do you have any new projects coming up besides voting for the Oscars?
I'm going to Paris.
Oh, fun.
And I'm conducting the orchestra.
What? Wonderful.
To Rocky.
Oh, good.
Gonna fly now.
Yeah.
Pa, 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 pa. Gonna fly now. And they're doing a documentary on my life. And it's it's all about the day that Elvis died. Because the day he died, I wrote a song. And it's called Last Song for Elvis. And I sat on my piano bench. And 38 years later, we're doing a film about it.
Wow. Well, you never know what will happen, do you?
And maybe next year, I'll even play golf. Because I'm the world's worst golfer. You okay. No. We're, you have no idea.
No, we're just here for fun.
I know, but nobody's going to want me on their team. I mean, I'm okay off the tee, but
I'm a terrible golfer too, Carol. So I'll join you on your team. So we'll be the come in last. We'll be the last place.
Last song for Elvis. Right, last that. Play for golf.
Anyway, well, congratulations,
thank
Carol,
you.
On all of this and. Keep your fingers crossed for Rocky.
I really, well, it's Creed. I mean,
yes,
he plays Rocky.
I know, but that's what.
But I really have a good feeling. I just.
Good.
I was with Sly right before I came at a function, and I gave him this really beautiful gift by Yakov Heller. He's an international sculptor, and it's comedy and tragedy. And Jennifer, his wife, took it, and I said, Sly, this is going to bring you good luck. Hey, okay, well, thanks so much.
Well, thank you, Carol Connors, thank for joining me. Thank you.
Mwah. Mwah. For sure, next year.
Okay, good. I hope you've enjoyed the interviews with all these crazy celebrities with the Frank Sinatra Celebrity Golf Invitational for 2016. Can't believe it's the 28th year. I want to thank everybody for supporting the Barbara Sinatra Children's Center and all the children that are blessed and taken care of at the Children's Center. And I want to thank all of the people involved with the golf tournament for allowing me to do this. I think this is my fifth year of doing the registration at Frank's Place. So thank you, and we'll join us again for the 29th annual Frank Sinatra Celebrity Golf Invitational.
For more information, email totdtv@questoffice.net. And visit talkofthedesert.tv on the web.
Start looking. Sit down.
Over the back.
Oh. What is this, Felix?
Man. Oh, yeah.
Bingo.
Beautiful.
That was a momentum killer. Man, we needed that, Alex.
That was two, right?
Thank you.
Oh,
that was awesome.
Nice putt.
Awesome.
We needed that badly.
Yeah,
we were losing steam and power. We had a lot of holes in our, but it's coming back now. We're coming back. So I would look out. Anybody thinks they can beat Team Sorbo's in trouble now. It's Hercules rules.
Nice to see you today.
Having fun, huh?
Yeah.
Nice
party.
Thank you.